When you're led by curiosity, I feel like you sort of let your guard down because you haven't already decided what it's going to be. Like that gives more opportunity for greater empathy, understanding, growth. The overall piece is an interdisciplinary piece of sound, sculpture, and movement, of gathering voices and perspectives of hope and success with Boston International Newcomers Academy and 826 Boston. I taught all the kids how to do simple voice recordings, so asking a family member what the family member hopes for them, how they define success. By the time I was done with Binka and 826, I had voice recorded 70 students.
If you want to live such a successful life, I think you need to follow.
And these kids were amazing. So I have these three component parts, all use the audio material from Binka. But the first movement is these sculptural costumes. The speakers actually fit inside the costumes, and then the dancers move through and immerse the audience. The second movement is a sculptural bench in which the sound is installed. And those are in Chinatown, Roxbury, Dorchester, Jamaica Plain, and West Roxbury. We're at the Boston Public Library Central Branch at Copley Square. And this third movement, it's a solo dancer, solo cello player, for whom I wrote a through-composed cello piece, and then the sound installation layered underneath of it.
She want me to have...
And Creative City provided opportunities for artists to take risks in producing their work, strengthening their voice, and sharing it and connecting it throughout the city. Very personally, it was a full-time job that I was doing, composing super early in the morning or late at night or on the weekends, and now I'm able to do it full-time because Creative City really helped provide that opportunity. It also provided a platform for really exciting connections and friendships and collaborators. Also really wonderful was meeting Peter DeMuro. So we collaborated on movement one, we're now collaborating on movement three, we're collaborating on his piece at the Isabella Stewart Gardner Museum. And those all happen through the Creative City connections. It's wonderful to have the autonomy and to do the work all on your own and to have creative license, and NIFA has been really very supportive of that. Being recognized as an artist who is being endorsed by NIFA has also been really huge. That this is a significant honor that I don't take lightly, and so it's been wonderful to be a part of that.